Hi, myself Professor Jitendra Engade, Senior Lecturer from Pravin Patil College of Diploma Engineering Technology. Today we are going to discuss paragraph and dialogue writing. Paragraph writing. Course outcomes. After completion of this topic, student able to learn the following course outcome from this topic or from this video. Student able to compose the dialogue and paragraph for different situations. Writing skills. Differentiate the given types of paragraph with justifications. Formulate a grammar paragraph in a word with synchronized sentence structure and given situation or topic. Explain the theme on given paragraph precisely. Speaking skills. Summarize the given paragraph with correct pronunciation and intonation. Take part in a debate with correct pronunciation and intonation using verbal non-verbal writing skills. Differentiate the given types of paragraph with justifications. Next, formulate a paragraph in a word with synchronized sentences and structure on the given situation or topic. Explain the theme on given paragraph precisely. These are the learning outcomes student will achieve after completion of this topic. Now, what is paragraph? So let us see what is paragraph. Okay. In your 8, 9, 10 standard, you all about discuss or learn the various types of news items, essay, etc., or short essay. So you are very much aware about the paragraph. What is paragraph? So let us see what is paragraph. Paragraph is a group of sentences organized around a central topic. Paragraph are compromised of sentences, but not random sentences. The cardinal rule of paragraph writing is to focus on one idea. A solidly written paragraph takes its reader on a clear path without distracting of ideas. A basic paragraph structure usually consists of the topic sentence, supporting sentence and concluding sentence. Students, paragraph writing is nothing but it's a depend on one central idea. From beginning line to last line, all information, idea, views, thought which will be write down in a paragraph of that particular topic. Do not put any other irrelevant information regarding that content or topic. Means that this is a basic structure of the paragraph. Paragraph writing is depend on one central idea only, and regarding that topic, short but sweetly information is provided in proper paragraph. It is a paragraph writing. Now, while writing paragraph, there are some elements we have to keep in our mind while writing paragraph. If we focus on these four elements, obviously we will write down the proper and well organized paragraph. A good paragraph has a focus for four essential elements, which when used correctly can change any average paragraph into the good or proper paragraph. So let us see what are the different types of essential element of good paragraph writing. Number one, unity. Number two, order. Number two, coherence. Number four, completeness. Okay. These are the four elements are very important while writing paragraph writing. If we focus on this element, obviously our paragraph is well organized, well framed and proper paragraph is there. So unity, what are the unity of thoughts? Let us see. Unity in a paragraph begins with the topic sentence. Means those are the topic sentence or those are the topic or title of the sentence. Okay, regarding that particular topic, regarding a particular title, number of sentence regarding that particular topic we are to put in the particular paragraph. Means the unity in the paragraph begins with a topic sentence. Every paragraph has a one single controlling idea that is expressed in the topic center. Every paragraph has its only one central idea, and regarding that central idea, regarding that topic, we put all types of information short but sweetly in the paragraph. Which is typically the first sentence of paragraph. द पैराग्राफ इज यूनिफाइड अराउंड इट्स मेन आइडिया विद द सपोर्टिंग सेंटेंस प्रोवाइडिंग डिटेल एंड डिस्कशंस. इन ऑर्डर टू राइट गुड टॉपिक सेंटेंसेस थिंक अबाउट यूअर थीम एंड ऑल द पॉइंट यू वॉन्ट टू स्टेट. डिसाइड विच पॉइंट ड्राइव द रेस्ट एंड देन राइट इट इज यूअर टॉपिक सेंटेंसेस. मीन्स द यूनिटी ऑफ थॉट वी हैव टू पुट इन अ पैराग्राफ. द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ एवरी पैराग्राफ इज कॉल्ड एज अ टाइटल लाइन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पैराग्राफ. टाइटल लाइन डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली सजेस्ट अस व्हाट अबाउट द इंफॉर्मेशन और व्हाट इज द टाइटल ऑफ द पैराग्राफ. मीन्स व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन यू आर पुटिंग इन द पैराग्राफ. इट इज वी जस्ट गेजिंग और गेटिंग द आइडिया फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट टाइटल लाइन. एंड रिगार्डिंग द टाइटल लाइन ऑल आवर आइडियाज और इंफॉर्मेशन आर सराउंडिंग और नियर कम टुगेदर रिगार्डिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. ओके एंड वाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ थॉट्स. वी हैव टू पुट ऑल द यूनिटी ऑफ दैट थॉट्स रिगार्डिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. डू नॉट पुट एनी एक्स्ट्रा और इरिलेवेंट इंफॉर्मेशन अनलेस दैट टॉपिक. ओके मीन ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन वी पुट द सेंट्रल आइडिया ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. नंबर सेकंड ऑर्डर. डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ थॉट्स कम्स इन योर माइंड. आइडिया कम्स इन योर माइंड. ओके हाउ टू स्टार्ट. विच इज द फर्स्ट वन विच इज द लास्ट वन. वी आर गेटिंग रियली कन्फ्यूज. नो हाउ टू पुट द प्रॉपर ऑर्डर. इफ वी पुट ऑल दिस आइडिया इन अ प्रॉपर ऑर्डर ऑब्वियसली अवर पैराग्राफ इज पैराग्राफ इज ऑल्सो वेल. इफ वी आर नॉट पुटिंग आइडिया इन अ प्रॉपर वे the all the ideas or information which you want to convey through your paragraph it is totally collapsed. So what is order? Order refer to the way organize your supporting sentences. Whether you choose chronological order, order of importance and other logical preference, presentation of detail. A solid paragraph always has a definite organization. In well ordered paragraph a reader follows on along easily aided by the pattern you have established. Order help the reader to grasp your meaning and avoid confusion. Means those are what are the different kinds of idea comes in your mind. You have to first of all arrange them in a proper systematical order. All the supporting sentences you have to arrange first of all in systematic order. Means chronological order, importance and so in a logical order according to the sequence. Then you have to put this idea in a paragraph and then your well ordered paragraph, well organized paragraph is framed. Then coherentness. Coherentness means relevance ideas or related idea. Coherence is a quality that make your writing understandable. Sentences within the paragraph need to connect to each other and work together as a whole. One of the best ways of achieve coherence is to use transition words. These words create bridge from the sentence to next sentence. You can use the transition words that shows order, spatial relationship, logic and also in a writing paragraph using the concise verb tense and point of view important the ingredient for coherence. Means number of thoughts come to your idea in our mind. Such ideas we put in a paragraph, then we put in a proper order. But those are the thought, those are the idea we collected from different kinds of sources or comes in our mind. We want to make it easy for understanding to the receiver and the put the sentence in those are only relevant to the subject or subject matter. If our information is not related to the subject or subject matter, the all the aim of paragraph writing is totally collapsed or it is vague to understanding to the receiver. That's why we put the relevant idea in the paragraph and also put in a proper systematical order, logical order in a paragraph. Also use a proper grammar, just like a verb, tenses, etc. And put all these things in a proper correctness or relevance idea. Last one, completeness. If all the sentence clearly and sufficiently support the main idea, then your paragraph is complete. If there are not enough sentences or enough information to prove your idea, then the paragraph is incomplete. Usually, three supporting sentences in addition to a topic, the paragraph is incomplete. The sentence and include the sentence are needed for the paragraph to be complete. Including the sentence or the last sentence of the paragraph should summarize the main idea by reinforcement of your topic. Means everything. Those are the tasks we are working. If it is incomplete, so all our effort, all our hard work remain foolish. Everything we want to give its fullness. And if we want to complete our paragraph, we want to get proper thing from our paragraph, we first of all want to complete the paragraph with a proper concluding line. If we are not complete the paragraph, we keep our paragraph in incomplete sense, obviously we didn't get a proper sense. But on the other hand, if we complete the paragraph with a proper supporting sentence, unity of thoughts, after description, by using supporting sentence, we conclude the sentence or the last sentence of the paragraph, which gives suggestions, which put the questions before the mind of the reader, it is also reinforcing your topic sentence or related to your topic sentence. Means we complete the sentence, we are using the completing sentence relevant to the subject matter. All these four elements, unity, order, coherence and completeness, is come in your paragraph, then your well organized or well framed paragraph is created. Types of paragraph. There are four types of paragraph, like technical, descriptive, narrative, compare and contrast types of paragraph. When considering the types of paragraph you are about to write, you need to consider a few different questions. What is the purpose of paragraph? What are you trying to communicate with your readers? Answer this question will guide you as you consider both content of paragraph and effect you are trying to achieve. There are many different types of paragraph. Each type has a different purpose and writer make use the different means in achieving purpose. So, basic aim, why we are writing the paragraph? What is the purpose of paragraph? Okay, the question obviously comes to your mind, and what about we are writing the paragraph? When we trying to convey this message to our reader, obviously our paragraph became well organized, well framed. So, there are the different kinds of paragraph. As per the it, we are dividing paragraph, that is four subtopic, that is technical, descriptive, narrative and compare and contrast. Let us see what is technical paragraph. Means what are the content we are assume or taking in technical types of paragraph. Number one, technical types of paragraph. This is a kind of paragraph is written or convey the technical information only. When writing such paragraph, one has to be very particular about the choice of word, grammatical structure and style of presentation. The technical paragraph should be clear or correct in the content and must be avoid any kinds of ambiguity or vagueness. Okay, means technical paragraph only provide technical kinds of information in that particular paragraph. Also, the choice of words, grammatical structure and style of presentation, it is only that related to that particular technical words or technical topics. And also when writing technical paragraph, use द वर्ड रिलेटेड टेक्निकल एंड डू नॉट यूज एनी इरिलेवेंट और वेग वर्ड इफ यू आर यूजिंग देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टॉपिक टू द रिसीवर सो अवॉइड एनी काइंड ऑफ वेगनेस और एम्बिग्यूटी यूज द एग्जैक्ट रिलेटेड टेक्निकल वर्ड नेक्स्ट डिस्क्रिप्टिव टाइप्स ऑफ पैराग्राफ इन दिस टाइप्स ऑफ पैराग्राफ डिस्क्राइब सम इवेंट और इंसिडेंट एंड शो द रीडर दैट अ थिंग और द पर्सन इज लाइक द वर्ड चूजन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफन अपील टू फाइव सेंस ऑफ टच स्मेल साइट एंड साउंड एंड टेस्ट द पर्पज ऑफ डिस्क्रिप्टिव पैराग्राफ इज अलाउ द रीडर टू एक्सपीरियंस द आइटम फेनोमिनन एंड इवेंट बिगिन डिस्क्राइब एज विविडली पॉसिबल विदाउट फिजिकली सेंसिंग इट That is the reader cannot see, but know what is look like. Cannot taste it, but know whether it is salty or sweet. Cannot touch it, but know it is a texture or descriptive. Descriptive paragraph typically include modifier, adjective, adverb, or prepositional phrases, etc., or configurative phrases. So, means we are describing the thing or incidents in descriptive paragraph by using various types of adjective adverb or give detailed information about that particular thing just like our five sensory organ perceive the sense from other thing and describing the thing or describing the object same we are describing the topic or incident or information in various types of describing paragraph for example sunset a scene at railway station etc we are describing the content narrative paragraph this types of paragraph tells us the story there is a sequence of action or there is a clear beginning middle and end of the paragraph narrative paragraph tells us stories two narrative paragraph however a similar or short story they are featured character follow a plot line conclude a conflict which is resolved and are told identifiable point of view means the narrative paragraph is narrative gives a narration just like a short story or any kinds of event or incident in a proper sequence one by one from beginning to ending okay. For example my favorite historical place an accident etc And last one, compare and contrast types of paragraph. In these types of paragraph, opening sentence name the two subject and state that they are very similar. Different have to mean important or interesting, similar or differentiation. Continue discussing similarities only using the compare and contrast. Keyword such like similar to and also each comparison. Then describe all differences using compare, contrast, crew words such as the differ, unlike, and other hand for each differences. Means in these types of paragraph, we are find out some similarities and find out some differentiation of that particular object. We are comparing the two thing, two object each other in the same line or in the same paragraph and find out their like. Dislike, differentiation and similarities by one to another. So students, while writing paragraph, we have to focus in our mind the four things such like unity, order, coherence,ness and last one that is completeness. If you have to using these four element in your paragraph, then your paragraph became well organized, well framed. It doesn't have any problem then also the different types of paragraph that is technical paragraph descriptive paragraph narrative paragraph and compare and contrast types of paragraph so these are the paragraph we will discuss or studied in our paragraph writing now I hope students all your doubt regarding technical types of paragraph compare and contrast types of paragraph descriptive types of paragraph and narrative types of paragraph will is clear then you also know that how to write the paragraph what are the four elements or what are the different types of elements will be occur in a paragraph you also know that unity order, coherence and completeness. If you are using such guidelines, then your paragraph became well organized, well framed, it doesn't have any problem. So I hope you understood the topic very well. Thank you very much.